Are you looking for a sign? Maybe this is it. Have you ever asked for a sign, even just generally, like a statement, not to anyone or anything specific, just said, well, I could really use a sign right now? Well, I want to talk about that. I want to talk about the fact that a lot of times when you Google or look up how to ask for a sign or look for signs, then there's a consistent message that I don't agree with, and I'm going to explain to you why. I think that it limits the possibilities of receiving signs, and it also limits your own power, and I'm going to explain why. First of all, I'll give you an example of how signs work. When you ask for a sign, it's usually out of a state of frustration, desperation, longing, and you need clarity on something. You don't know how to make a decision, you feel conflicted. Everything is typically, when you're asking for a sign, coming from a source of angst. And that carries its own energy, right? So you'll be told to look for something, like create something specific, random, and focus on that. And when you see that, that'll be your answer. So there's a psychological reason why this can be a problem. And that is what the Urban Dictionary calls blue car syndrome. This is when, let's say, it's kind of like the I Spy game. When you're standing in a parking lot and you close your eyes and you say, I'm going to open my eyes and look for yellow cars. And instantly yellow cars just pop out at you. I used to do this in a convention where 5,000 people would be seated and I'd sit and I'd close my eyes. I want to see everyone wearing green. And then I'd open my eyes and boom, all the green outfits would pop out. And then I'd close my eyes and pick a different color and boom, that color was prominent. What happens is this is a sort of cognitive bias. It's called frequency illusion. And it's a confirmation bias that creates selective attention. And it trains our brain almost immediately to look for something specific. And we can see why that would be a nice quality or condition to have, especially when you lose something and you're looking for something specific, or you're doing research and you want to find something specific. It really helps you focus. But the problem is you're going to create a solution to something, and it's based out of this angsty, unhealthy ego state. And it's also based out of lack. It's saying that I don't have enough, I don't have the answer, I don't have any of my power, I have lost my connection to everything, to the universe, to God, to spirit, to nature, to whatever it is that resonates most with you, okay? So we all have our different way of looking at things spiritually. So whatever language works best for you, it's all correct. Because I'm going to speak specifically for you. My way isn't the way. It's just my way and what resonates with me personally. If we use this method, we are limiting our ability to see signs that, or receive answers or receive whatever we're asking for in a way that we could not have possibly imagined. And we're also saying that we are not already connected to everything that exists. Imagine yourself as the roots of the tree network. Science has proven that trees communicate with each other in underground networks. It's proven how the universe communicates with itself out in the ethos. And we aren't any different. We all have an energetic frequency that's measured and measurable. Even our organs have different megahertz that comes out of each organ that it produces. Plants have their own frequency that is measurable. You can measure it in essential oils. Like, all of this is measurable energy, and energy never dies. Okay? So if you are limiting your ability to recognize that you already probably can see an answer, at least in first steps to take towards a goal or to gain greater clarity, then you're forgetting your own power and your own divinity. Regardless of whether you believe in God or not, there's still divinity in life itself, in nature, in the power of the cosmos. So I'm going to give you an example. Let's say that here's how to find a sign or know that you're getting a sign. You're going to feel something visceral within you. Like the other day, my boyfriend came up the stairs, and he came up 4 flights of stairs carrying all kinds of groceries, never touched, put the groceries on the ground or anything, but a random large feather was attached to him, medium-sized feather, but still, it somehow traveled with him the entire way. And something, and we're not around nature, we're in the middle of a city. So that, and you get kind of goosebumps, like, oh my goodness. Those are the kind of things that I mean. And it will come to you in a language you understand that resonates with you. So for me, I'm all about nature and animals. And I'll have a dream, like the other night I had a dream about a baby hippo floating upside down. And realized that it had to do with how I feel about my life. I feel fluid and happy and joyful and youthful because I'm getting everything I wanted as a child now. But I don't like myself, and I'm upset with myself because I can't figure out how to brand myself or how to put myself out there in a marketable way, and I'm still conflicted on that. So I beat myself up. And that's what the dream was telling me. And so I asked for a more clear sign, but I'm also, the way I was specific was, I said, if I meant to have a marketable way to brand myself before I'm called back to work because I'm currently furloughed, then I will. It'll get clearer. And I can start working on that and writing, knowing that this is the foundation of the message I want to put out into the world. And if I don't come up with it before I'm called to go back to work, I will continue to research and do some reading that I've been wanting to do to kind of look more at myself and who I am and how to brand myself, read the books that I've been meaning to read that I've been putting off, that sort of thing. And I have to just trust in divine timing, the greatest good of all. What's the best timing for me and everybody else that I may or may not influence? And I was called to come back to work in a temporary position until my clinic opened up, not within a day or two after that. But the key here is I finally accepted and relaxed into a state. Instead of pushing and forcing, I was pushing everything away from me. Not only was I could have probably been pushing the opportunity to go back to work away and make money, but I was also pushing away the opportunity to make money on my own because I was trying to force something that just wasn't ready. And my confirmation was, it's not time yet. I can go back to work and start making money. I can keep reading. I can keep working on it. No, I'm actively working on it. But just relax into the flow of everything instead of trying to force it, because I do try to force things. That is my nature. So I wasn't overly specific about what I wanted. I just am putting trust into my intention, into my asking for a sign. I'm taking responsibility at the same time and what my role is, but also being open to the possibilities. And, you know, I also had this background intention of, or maybe another opportunity will come up that I can't even imagine that will offer me even more clarity on what my purpose is and what I should be doing now if it's something other than sitting here furloughed in my home doing nothing and not feeling productive, because I like to feel productive. So I just want to leave you with those examples and let you know that you have the power within you. Your subconscious is constantly communicating with you. If something in nature or in the world or something starts recurring, or you notice something that your conscious brain hasn't thought about, but it just kind of hits you in a certain way, then follow that prompt. I'm not saying it's a sign. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. That's up to you. But they are prompts, and it might be taking you closer to what it is you're looking for. Be open to the fact that whether it's God or the universe, your subconscious, nature, divinity, whatever, spirit, something is communicating a message to you to help you along your path. And we're left tiny little breadcrumbs. And we can't be too distracted by looking to see if there should be stepping stones that look a certain way to follow on our path. And the breadcrumbs might be a little smaller, but they might be more abundant also. So just kind of keep that in mind when you're looking for signs. Trust yourself. Be somewhat specific about who you are, what language resonates with you. If you need a sign about a loved one that's passed or something, maybe something that was shared between you, even if it's a scent or something like that. You can be specific, but also open to the possibility that it may come another way that you never imagined. And when that happens, because it's happened with me multiple times, it's like your world gets blown open in the most beautiful way. And you will just realize how incredibly important and valuable you are. And it's more confirming of your value and importance and your personal power than if you're using a psychological trick to trick your brain into looking for one specific thing. And when you see it, then you feel validated. Because I can assure you that sometimes the things that come that you don't see coming at the time you don't quite expect are going to hit you in a more powerful and beautiful, life-changing way than the things you think you're supposed to see or you think you're supposed to get. So I'm going to leave you with that. I'm going to ask you to surrender, which is a big deal for an Aries to say. Surrender to your own power and to your power of everything you're connected to and your energy. And know that when you are coming from a space of abundant thinking and confidence and assuredness and trust that everything comes when it's meant to, then you will be amazed at the results. You just have to be a little more patient, which is a little frustrating, I know, but you can do it. So if you were looking for a sign, I think this might be it.